name is Dr. Esther Trufant, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to extract flavors from mint leaves using water and oil. For this experiment, we're going to need a couple items, something like a plate or a piece of paper, or in my case, a weighing boat to cut up some mint. We're also going to need something to cut it up with. I'm going to use scissors, but you can use a knife and a cutting board. That's okay too. And then finally, I'm going to use four of these screw top vials that are going to contain two water solutions and two oil solutions. So then onto my materials. I will need some oil. I'm going to use canola oil. I will need some water, and I'm going to have some here. This is deionized water, and I recommend that for this experiment, you also use one. And I'm going to use mint today, but you can use any other herb or fruit or vegetable to extract flavoring. This can be done with basil or sage or anything that you find around the house. So I'm going to extract only two mint leaves from here, because for one part of the experiment, I'm going to need a large chunk. So I'll just take this and then cut it into larger pieces. I will place one of these large chunks into a screw top vial. And then add approximately 12 to 13 milliliters of water to it. And then I will try to convince that sprig of mint to go under the water layer. For the next screw top vial, I'm going to take the same piece, the same sized piece of mint, and I am going to cut it in small bits. Once I have it in small enough pieces, I'm going to transfer those little pieces into the screw cap vial and add the same amount of water to it. And just like before, I will try to keep the mint leaves under the water level. Next, I will take the same mint leaf, cut off a larger piece, place it in a screw top vial, and then add my oil to it. It doesn't have to be canola oil. It can be any oil that doesn't have its own smell. I added between 12 and 13 milliliters of oil to this. And then for my final vial, I'm going to add tiny cuts of mint, and I will pour the oil on top as well. And now the oil. And if you're not quite comfortable maneuvering such a large container of oil, you can always transfer it into a small container and use it from there. All right. Now that we're done with the mint, the oil, and the water and the scissors, we can set them aside and focus on evaluating our experiment. Now for each of these, we already know what's inside just by looking at it, but if you're not sure, you can always label your vials. For each of these, you want to shake them really, really well a few times. Make sure that there is nice contact between the oil or the water and the mint leaves. And then leave it out for at least 15 minutes or so before you attempt to do the following. The first is going to be a simple smell test. And you're going to identify your water with the large piece of mint and your water with the small pieces of mint. And you will open up each of the vials and you will smell it. And you will need to decide which one smells more minty, which one has the higher intensity of mint essence. And then you do the same exact thing with the oil, with the mint leaf that is whole, almost whole in your oil, and the mint leaf that is suspended in little bits. And then for all of these, you do the same kind of smell test. There are different compounds that are responsible for the smell of herbs. What we are looking for in this very simple experiment is to determine whether the compound that is responsible for the smell of mint is more water soluble or oil soluble.